నారాణి సిఎస్సి హెచ్ఓడి, వేణు అకాడమిక్ కోఆర్డినేటర్ సిఎస్సి డిపార్ట్మెంట్, మైపా ఈసీ హెచ్ఓడి, ఆస్కా అండ్ ఆస్కా సివిల్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ హెచ్ఓడి అండ్ వేణు. నెక్స్ట్ వీ హావ్ గెస్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ విశ్వా డిజిటల్, మిస్టర్ పండితాజు అండ్ మీకు కిరణ్ అండ్ సాయి కిరణ్ ఫర్ దిస్ సెమినార్. అండ్ మై డియర్ ఫ్యాకల్టీ అండ్ మై డియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్, వెరీ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ టు ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యు. టుడే ఐ ఇన్వైట్ అండ్ వెల్కమ్ ఆల్ ది డిగ్నిటరీస్, ఫ్యాకల్టీ అండ్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఫర్ దిస్ సెమినార్ ఆన్ ఐటీ హబ్ అట్ నిజామాబాద్, its prospects and developments. We are fortunate enough to have the IT Hub at Nizamabad. At this juncture, it is my responsibility to say thanks to our beloved Chief Minister KCR Garu for sanctioning an amount of rupees 25 crores for the establishment of IT Hub in Nizamabad. At the same time, we have to be thankful for young, dynamic IT Minister Sri KKR Garu for this gesture to our Indoor city. And I need to thank MP Kavita Garu and MP Jeevan Reddy Garu, MLA Ganesh Gupta Garu and others who have contributed for this bringing IT Hub to Nizamabad. And 20 multinational companies are willing to come and participate in developing IT Hub, IT Hub in Nizamabad. This is a very good news to all of you, all of us. Any city develops with modernization. What will happen if idea of has come? Just some people may ask. Hyderabad, if you observe, earlier, most of the people in the world do not know the name of Hyderabad much. But once the IT blossomed in Hyderabad and branched out, and many technical people, IT experts, have migrated to America, and also outsourcing has been done in Hyderabad, and so many softwares were developed in Hyderabad. At that time, the whole world came to know there is a place in Andhra Pradesh called Hyderabad, which is full of IT and teaching educated people. Even you know that Clinton has come, President of USA has also visited Hyderabad at that when it's brought. That means any big industry like either software or industry that comes into any place, definitely the appearance and complexion of that city will be going to change. That means the economy in that area is going to completely change. Already Indoor city, Indoor area is famous for its agriculture. Here most of the agricultural products are sold from this place, enriched with agriculture. Now to this we are going to add the IT hub. So many IT industries come. Now even smart farming also is possible. That means IT will help the agriculture to take modern, utilize modern techniques. And now technological entry in any place, as I told you, will change total picture of a place. Mainly economic development, skilled, semi-skilled and unskilled people will have employment. and students especially will get benefited. Training institutes will start, software development will take, more startups, more technological development, manufacturing sector will develop, service sector will develop, business will develop, and resulting the real estate also to develop, and there will be totally the overall economic development, and for the people who are doing here, employment potential will be very high. And within few years, we can see a total change in the Indian city regarding the people's attitude, because modern technology is going to play and people getting jobs here itself. There is no need of going elsewhere, far away distances, in search of jobs. And living style of the people also will change. Health, hospitals will develop, hotels will develop, commerce, and better utilization of human resources and traveling procedures will be done. And here, so overall economic development is possible in the city in the few years. For this, we have to thank our government. And I take this opportunity for our Vishal Digital people have come here to show that our college, our management, Rajni sir, Madam Vijayashmi sir, and Director Teja Madam Garu, Raja Garu, and Aboji Garu, all are very happy because our students will get jobs. And I thank digital people who have come here to cover our seminar program, and I thank all the organizers and agreements. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon to one and all. So today we have gathered here to conduct a seminar on IT Hub at Nizamabad and its prospects and developments. So before going into that, we must thank, already our principal sir has expressed his thanks to all the persons who are involved in bringing that IT Hub to the Nizamabad. Okay. So our dynamic always for anything, he will be the first person to sanction and sanction. He is none other than our CM, KCR, who has sanctioned 25 crores instantly and Now, I am the building also, and I started establishing that idea instead of constructing a new building and waiting for that. We must thank him to giving this opportunity to Nizamabad itself. And the second person is none other than our young and dynamic IT minister, KTR. So now all the states are thinking, why we are not having this kind of minister? So you might be observing his speeches and all, how he delivers, how subject knowledge is having. Because he has worked in IT in US and he came back here. So he's having a lot of knowledge on IT. So he's the man behind bringing ITIR to Hyderabad also. You all know ITIR has come to Hyderabad. Central government has given ITIR to only one city, that is none other than Hyderabad. So now, for this also, he's the first person to sanction it immediately. And those who are persuaded for this is our MP, Kavita Madam, and our MLA, my Bigala Ganesh Gupta Garu, and other MLA, Jeevan Reddy Garu. So all these are the persons who are behind this, and directly, indirectly, they have involved, and other leaders, our ministers also involved in that, and they have brought it to the Nizamabad. So we are lucky enough to have IT Hub at Nizamabad. So what are the, so this is one side, bringing IT Hub to the Nizamabad. Okay. So other end is, what are the benefits we are going to get with that? And what way we can utilize that opportunity? We got the opportunity now. So it all, getting the opportunity is one way, utilizing it is the other way, right? If you get it and if you are not able to utilize it, that is no use. Okay. So now, till now, if you ask anybody, if anybody says that I am doing IT job, Nizamabad is also now one of the good colleges in state, right? So same situation is going to come for the IT jobs also. When you are studying here, you don't need to move to the other places, far away places, because being a girls, especially for the girls, going far up and staying in hostels and instead of that, you can stay in our hometown and you can do the software job also. Software job, ante manam bayatiki vellalse undedi, ippudu ikkada dorike chance ledu manam. Ippudu short period lo, maybe by the time you come out, we expect that it will be coming into action, right? So third years, 5 years, you may get opportunity to work here also, there, because there are already 50 MNCs waiting for this idea. Okay. And this is not only jobs, creation of jobs. With IT Hub, as our principals have said earlier, we can utilize the IT, we can implement this IT in so many areas. You are seeing now, IT can be implemented anywhere. So we have a lot of industry, like rice mills, agricultures, right? So in those areas we can implement our IT, and with this IT hub, we can develop industrially also, okay? And exports also will increase, our economic scenario also will change. Nizamabad economic scenario also is going to change. So this, I expect that this is going to bring a lot of changes to Nizamabad. Within a short period, Nizamabad is going to be different from earlier Nizamabad.
When we have completed my graduation in the year of 2002, at that time, we are not having this technological development. When we are doing our project to collect the information from the resources, we are using the internet. For that, we have traveled from Miapur to Amirpet by paying 160 rupees per hour. We have collected the information. But nowadays, we are having the technological developments and we are having the world in our hand. Clear? And we are going to collect the any information. First of all, what is an IT hub? IT hub is a place where your ideas are going to be encouraged and cultivated. And at the same time, this is a place where we are going to implement what we are going to consider. And it is a platform. At the time, we are not having the platform to exhibit our ideas. Now we are having an opportunity, we are having an IT Hub in Nizamabad. and it is a good platform to share our ideas with the experts. By that we are going to fulfill your dreams. For that purpose, try to utilize this particular IT hub and try to explore your ideas in the technology. And by that, try to develop yourself and try to contribute for the development of our nation. And try to utilize this particular IT hub in a proper way. By the end of your graduation, this may comes into force. By that time, try to have your own ideas and try to share your ideas with the other things. Clear? Only CSE engineers cannot do anything, or ECE people cannot do anything, or civil people cannot do anything, or PPE people cannot do anything. Nowadays, in order to execute a particular task, we require the coordination among all the engineers. The computer engineers may not be aware of the actual inner things of the other branches. In order to program that particular thing, definitely you need to take the help from the other engineers. For that purpose, integration is going to be required and coordination is going to be required. For that purpose, try to take the help from your neighboring friends. Here, some are going to be expert in some fields. Try to take the help from that particular people and try to implement your ideas in a valid way and try to achieve your...
Kavita Madam Garu has given a request to KPR Garu to start a IT hub in the Nizamabad district. So with that, the government, our Chief Minister KCR Garu has sanctioned 25 crores to the Nizamabad district. So as soon as possible, we hope that number of industries are going to start in the Nizamabad district. And one more thing, APR Garu has taken three initiatives after forming the Telangana state. The first one is high tech, that is T-Hub, an IT industry in the Nizamabad district. The coming days, we hope that the Nizamabad district of the Telangana state will be become a high tech Nizamabad district in our Telangana state. After starting this task program, number of students have improved their technical skills by joining this task program. Most of the students, now the students from the rural area, if they want to learn a course, most of the families, that is most of the parents will think that the students, I think that my students should send, that my children should send to Hyderabad. We take some risk to send those children to Hyderabad. Now the people, the parents, now they are very glad to say that since the IT industries are going to start in the Nizamabad district, every educated people will be get employed and every student who is living in and around the places of the Nizamabad district will be get educated and will compulsory employment will be gained to the students if that IT industries is started in the Nizamabad district. So I hope that I am very thankful to our management, Rajnikant sir Garu, Teja Madam Garu, Vijayashmi Madam Garu, that number of students in each and every area from our engineering college, they are going out and they are joining in the other states to certain jobs or MS or anything. But most of the students now will be get settled in the Nizamabad district and they are very proud to say that we are the students of Kakatiya and we have placed in industry within this Nizamabad district or within our home town.
So, it will be very happy news for us, because few people will get more opportunities in the future. Our state government visualizes the importance of IT, information technology, and its critical role, crucial role in the development, social and economical development of our society and state. So, I am very thankful to state government, CM Garu and IT Minister and MPs and MLS for bringing IT up to Nizamabad. And IT Hub, little bit I will tell about ECE. So ECE, if you go for software or core side, hardware will be there to design that hardware or to control that hardware, again we need software. So that's why we are very closely related to information technology. So we are the part of information technology. So if you improve programming skills, definitely you will get good opportunities in the future. And one more thing, there will be lot of ideas and innovative thoughts for the students. For we need a good platform to implement those ideas and innovative thoughts. So now we are getting a good platform at our Nizamabad only to implement our. But because of this resources, lack of resources, those ideas are not implementing. So now we are getting a good platform to implement those ideas. So it is very good situation. And
I would like to thank our Telangana government for taking an initiative to bring up an IT hub in our Nizamabad district. So here with the coming of this IT hub in this Nizamabad district, so will create a lot of opportunities, and it will be encouraging our students of this district to get jobs in our district itself. Otherwise, most of the students after completing their education, graduation, they are migrating to cities like Hyderabad, Bangalore or out of this country. But now we have, all our students have an opportunity to get the job here in our Nizamabad district itself. And here I would like to say about civil engineering. Here the type of infrastructure and building that is required for an IT hub and IT company is completely different. Whatever we are seeing, regular buildings which we will be seeing here in the Nizamabad districts, it will be a completely different infrastructure of building. So for IT hub, we require an innovative design, attractive elevation is required, big and spacious buildings are required, top class construction and international safety standards are required for. So my dear students, you have a better opportunity, a good opportunity to show your talent, you have first class structure for your IT hub here in our Nizamabad district. And this IT hub also act as an incubator for the students who have their innovative ideas. So who want to hear from the rural background. So we will be facing some problems with the innovative ideas here in with this IT hub. Will be encouraged, students will be encouraged to give their ideas, innovate to solve these scientific problems. So what my suggestion for you all is to utilize this best opportunity and try to settle up in your dream jobs. And
what is IT?
Information technology.
What is information technology? What is information technology?
I think it's the computer at the store.
It's the application of computer. Simply it's the application of computer to store the information, to retrieve the information, to analyze the information, to manipulate the information. Great. To manipulate the information in the aspects of business operations. The aspects of business operations are in other enterprises. It's a wing of IT and IT department under the Minister Sri K.T. Agarwal, and it is the world fastest growing economic activity in the world. If you see the statistics of 2016, the contribution of this IT in Indian market is around 7.7%. It's a huge measure. Until today, rural area people are educated person has to shift to the urban areas like Hyderabad. From Nizamabad is a rural area. And once you complete, we are going to enjoy the fruits in three angles. One is, it is going to create lot of employment opportunities for all common people and educated students. And the second benefit of this IT industry is infrastructure development. And third is the quality education to the students. So employment opportunities, only engineering graduates are going to enjoy this ITM. All the graduates, engineering and non-engineering, let me clearly elaborate this. So you are going to get a direct employment, and some people are going to enjoy the indirect employment. under the direct employment, the core branch students like ECE, CSE, Triple E and various engineering students who are belongs to the core branch are going to settle as a IT developers. And the non-technical students in any software industry, there is a proportionate employment between the IT developers and the HRs. HRs are basically from the MBA department. So in MBA students are also going to get an opportunity, employment opportunity directly. And call centers, BA, BCom, BSc, students who are having a sound knowledge in aptitude and communication skills are going to get the employment opportunity. If you understand this, so all undergraduate students who are having the sound knowledge in the required platform are going to get the employment directly. So to get the opportunity in the employment opportunity in this industry, we should have a update knowledge on the latest technologies like mobile applications. Since I belong to a computer science background, I tell the latest technologies like mobile apps, online, web technologies, web programming, software quality testing, database administration, animation, gaming, digital film production, digital marketing. So all these are the latest technologies. If you have a sound knowledge at least in at least one subject, then definitely you are going to settle in IT industry in Nizamabad district, and with the it is an easy chance for getting the employment opportunity in our local district. Moreover, for girl students, it's a great opportunity. And the indirect employment is also there. So IT professionals need transportation.
Telecommunications been all over. But here we are seeing most of the graduates compared BTech, MCA, MBA. Even there are some people who are doing BTech and driving autos, bus drivers. Why are they going there? Due to the lack of the opportunities. But this is the right chance. They can gain the opportunity now. Those people will feel very happy. Not only they, most of the female, even consider for me, for example, without leaving my family, I can't stay. So I didn't leave this place. I stayed here itself. So there are many people, all the people who are existing in other field, doesn't mean that they don't have a living in that places, a long distances. These are some of the disadvantages that didn't settle in there. The BTech people with BTech degree, MBA, MC, whatever the graduation you may take, what sector they are trained in, they are not able to be in that sector due to privileges which not available for them to participate. So now, if this IT hub has emerged, most of the people will get opportunities. So students, now this is only chance to you to get prepared. So to get prepared, you need complete dedication, hard work, and especially smart work. I think world today is running so fast today. Don't think the technologies which you know today are final. For example, I'll tell you, you are seeing now biometric iris techniques. But now systems in future are going to emerge. For example, if I'm sitting in front of a system, that system is going to scan my heart with its diameter. If my heart is matching that diameter, then only it will allow me to use that system. Otherwise, we cannot use that system. So many secure applications are going to emerge in future. So it is up to you, up to what extent you will prepare and you will be ready. Not only this, advanced communication technologies and quantitative aptitude things, these all things you need to get prepared and always be, first you learn basics with what you are. First, KTR sir only said this, sir, for KTR sir, KCR said it since, it is not always necessary to learn new things. First, we need to know existing things. From that we can learn new things. If you are able to know existing things, from that new things will come automatically. Because if you are today, for updates we will look after. So that is the scope to learn new things. So students, I wish you all the best and be prepared well. And you should be there shortly once it has emerged in the Nizamabad. Thank you.